Sorry, we're a little bit late, running behind for some reason tonight. In front of you is the Symphonic Band, and welcome to the Symphonic Band Spring Concert. We're excited to have you guys. This is a 7th and 8th grade group that meets together daily, just as you see them here. And they've grown a lot this year through competitions, all regions, so an ensemble. We'll talk a lot about that stuff in the coming moments here. Tonight they'll be performing various songs. Some of them will be receiving awards. Please remember that please don't use flash photography because that can interrupt their focus. And then please silence your cell phones as well. If you need to leave the auditorium for any reason, please make sure you do that in between songs, unless it's an emergency. All right, so Critical Mass is the first song they're playing. It's a scientific term that refers to the smallest amount of fissile material needed to maintain a nuclear chain reaction. The work begins with an explosion of sound, then launches forward with small, ever-growing melodic fragments that expand outward and upward. This is Critical Mass by Todd Stelter. Participated in our ASBOA Region 6 Solo Ensemble Contest. And as a side note, if you guys helped out in any way, donating money, donating food, drinks, helping out and volunteering your time, we would like to, anybody, the students would like to, and myself and you guys as well, please give them a round of applause for helping out with this event. This is my first time ever hosting that event. It went super smooth, and it's only because of the parents. I was wearing a lot of hats, and then I ended up giving them to other people. That's a metaphor of not really wearing a lot of hats. Anyway, so really good event, and they were really successful with it, and we'd like to honor some of them. And if you guys don't know what that event looks like, they prepare a solo or an ensemble, and they play in front of a judge, and that judge gives them a rating of 1 through 5. 1 is the best that they could possibly get, and 5 is the worst. We give medals out to the first and second division winners of this. One thing I do want to note about this is I never once helped anybody with their solo or ensemble. That was not my job. I said, you guys, you can pick as many ensembles or solos you want to be in, and you have to learn it all on your own. It's all completely up to you. And so some of these guys, they learned a lot from that. Some of them ended up picking like 8 different things, and I'm like, okay, good luck. You have 8 different things you have to prepare. And they may have kind of failed on it. Some of them only picked 1, and they're like, oh, I'm really successful, I got that 1 down. So they learned a lot from it, and it's a good experience for them to play something outside of the regular band room. That's enough of me talking. Here is our second division rating winners, and students, when we call your name, just go ahead and come up here, and we will recognize you. Mom and Dad can take a snapshot of you getting your medal and embarrass you. Wait, don't go, don't leave yet, though. Okay, here we go. Mackenzie Woods receiving a second division medal. Sasha Ponto on her solo. Wait, no, I'm sorry. Sasha, you got a 1 on the solo. I didn't change mine. Never mind. Amelia Spear, 2 pigeon on her solo. Haley Hunter. Max Delgado. David Nava. Alex Wells. Anthony Almarez. And JT Miller. And scoring a second division on their ensembles are Marlene Martinez with a member of the concert band. Amory Wyatt and Amelia Spear. Mackenzie Woods and Carla Ingman. Rune Hawkins and Adrian Salazar. Adrian, didn't you forget your music in the room? Okay, yeah. He didn't even have his music in the room, but he managed to squeak out it too. All right, please congratulate all these second division winners. Receiving a first division on their solo, we have Emery Wyatt. Sasha Ponto, yeah. Johanna Chang, yeah. Marlene Martinez, yeah. Ashley Madewell, yeah. Kim Martinez, yeah. Olivia Bybrooks, Rune Hawkins, yeah. Will Henley, yeah. Jillian Antelope, yeah. Andrew Weedman, Jesse, yeah. Stanberry, yeah. Emily Bridges, Jennifer Mendez, Hudson Sell, Jacob Petun, Adrian Salazar, he remembered his music for the solo. All right, Brian Estrada. Aiden McPike. Cole Taylor and Johanna Chang for their duet. For their duet, Emily Bridges and Ruthie McCain. Eliza Adams and Tate Hinkle for their duet. Jaden Arnoldus May and Janet Zendejas for their duet. Will Henley and Alan Guzman for their duet. Michael Rubio, Skylar Cannon, and Wilson Bass for their trio. Addison Wicklin, Marlene Martinez, Nisa Sheik, and Emery Wyatt for their quartet. What? Shane? Sorry, Shane. Noah Milner, Caleb Hutchins, Angel Sandoval, and Palmer Jurgensmeyer for their quartet. All right, please give them a giant round of applause. That's all first of the year. Oh, we had another quartet, right? Who was it? Olivia, Sasha? I'm sorry, I don't know why it's not on here. Olivia, Sasha, who else was it? Johanna, and Carlin. They had a quartet too, I'm sorry. Okay. If you did not, don't get mad at me, I'm sorry. If you did not get a medal for one of those events because I'm a failure at life and didn't count right, then I will get you one later on, I promise. Yeah. All right, you guys go sit down. I think last year I had like 12 make medals, so this is a lot. Oh, Carlin, Olivia, Sasha, Johanna, I found it. It's on the top of the next page. All right, up next, we're gonna play a song, a little jazz section that features our saxophone called In the Mood. Thank you. I'm sorry I have to talk so much in this concert, but this is also partly an award ceremony. We have so many students to recognize in this group, as you can see by all the ridiculous symbols that are next to their names in the programs. All right, so up next, we're going to recognize a few students that went above and beyond this year, and these students worked for months, completely on their own, on audition material, and they competed against over, I'd say probably close to 500, anywhere between 500 and 700 students that were 7th, 8th, and 9th graders for a limited amount of spots in the ASBOA Region 6 All-Region Band. This is a huge feat for them. Now, they were my guinea pig class. This is the first class I've ever said, all right, you have to try out. Because what I was noticing is, last year we had 8 kids make it. The year before we had 2 kids make it. The year before that I had like 4 kids make it. And I was noticing that, like, my kids, even at the All-Region Clinic, I was watching the kids play. I was like, my kids are better than those kids, and they should be in this band. And so I was like, well, let's just try it. Let's just make them try out. And sure enough, it paid off. This year we had 30 kids total make it in the All-Region Clinic. So just like doing the dishes, sometimes if you make them do it, they're like, oh, okay, it's nice to not eat off the dirty dishes. So they were forced to, and it paid off. I'd also like to recognize a few students in this group that are 7th graders that made the All-Region group. And I told you, 7th, 8th, and 9th graders are competing for these spots. So it's really a big feat for those kids to make it, especially as a 7th grader. That's very, very difficult to do. So, students, when I call your name, please come up here. You're going to receive a patch. And again, you guys can take more pictures if you want to. Put it on the Instagram. All right, first off, we've got Olivia Vibrox making first band, third chair flute. And some of these chairs, I think they may have changed because people were gone, so I'm sorry if I didn't have the right accurate, but it's okay. Ashley Madewell, first band, 10th chair flute. Amelia Spear, second band, first chair flute. Eileen Hernandez, second band, fourth chair flute. Johanna Chang, first band, fourth chair clarinet. Sasha Ponzo, first band, 10th chair clarinet. Mackenzie Woods, first band, 16th chair clarinet. Carlin Ingman, first band, 21st chair clarinet. Nisa Sheikh, second band, second chair clarinet. Noah Milner, second band, 16th chair clarinet. Marlene Martinez, second band, 17th chair clarinet. Emery Wyatt, second band, 21st chair clarinet. I'm not sure what chair you're talking about. Ruthie McCain, second band, third chair tenor sax. Rune Hawkins, first band, fifth chair horn. Will Henley, second band, sixth chair horn. Anthony Almaraz, first band, ninth chair trumpet. Adrian Salazar, second band, third chair trumpet. Brian Estrada, second band, fourth chair trumpet. Wilson Bass, second band, seventh chair trumpet. Tate Eagle, second band, 10th chair trumpet. Alex Wells, second band, 12th chair trumpet. Jacob Petum, second band, 9th chair trombone. Aiden Pott, second band, 5th chair tuba. Andrew Weedman, first band, third chair percussion. Jesse Stanberry, first band, ninth chair percussion. Caleb Hudgens, second band, second chair percussion. And finally, Jillian Angelic, second band, 10th chair percussion. Big round of applause for all of our all-region participants. Anybody audition for what's called All Region Orchestra. And All Region Orchestra is a little bit of a difference. It's kind of like All Region, but they're technically competing against half of the state of Arkansas for these spots. And in terms of spots that are available, we're talking there's like two flutes spots, there's like four clarinet spots, there's like five trumpet spots. I don't remember, but it's so limited. And they get to participate in a full orchestra situation where they're playing with string instruments and they're playing with percussion and brass and woodwinds. It's all together. And it's a super cool event. I did not plan on having any of my kids audition for it, but one of my kids asked about it and I was like, sure, let's just do it, that's fine. And I think you guys would be surprised. There's so many people that talk bad about this younger generation, but you would be surprised at how much they drive the program above what I do. They really push me, and I never, like, All Region Orchestra was not on my radar at all. And so we tried it, and we had three of our members make it, which is incredible to think that they're competing for such limited spots in half the state. So we'll recognize those people now. We have Olivia Vibrix making second chair flute. Adrian Salazar making third chair trumpet. Andrew Weedman making first chair percussion. Okay, you can sit down. Yeah, I'm super proud of them. And it was such a cool event for them, and I think they really enjoyed it. And maybe next year we'll have even more people make it, who knows? All right, our next piece is one of my favorite films, and it's called Highlights from How to Train Your Dragon. Thank you. In March, this group participated in the ASBOA Region 6 Concert Assessment. And there, each band from the region is given a rating of a 1 to 5. It's kind of like solo ensemble, but it's for the entire group. And 1 is the best rating that they can achieve, 5 is the worst. There's also a sight reading song that they have to, they have 6 minutes to look over it, and then they can't play in that 6 minutes at all, and then they have to play the entire song in front of a judge right after that. And it's a really, really high stakes, high intensity part of their assessment. But during that time, guys, they did a great job on stage, did a great job in the sight reading room. I know some of you guys probably came to that. And they received a Division I Superior rating on the stage and a Division I Superior in sight reading that day. Please give them a round of applause. That's probably one of the hardest competitions that they do all year because everybody is important. There's not really a sideline or a bench or anything like that. Like, everybody has to be able to play. And those judges are old band directors that know all the music that we're playing, and they know the ins and outs of it, and they know exactly if somebody's not playing or they're playing the wrong thing. So it's really, really intense on them. The next thing I'd like to say is for these guys, I've got a few awards to hand out to individuals. And I don't typically like to do individual awards because this is such a team environment. But there's always a handful of people that really stand out. And I could have probably given these awards to countless people in this group. It's been a tremendous honor working with these guys. And they're such hard workers. That's evident by all the tests that they submit. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. You guys should listen to some of these tests that they submit, and it blows me away. How good they are. Some of them, they have tears streaming down their eyes because I can tell they've been working for 2 hours on this test and they want it absolutely perfect. And I'm like, it sounds awesome. I don't know what you're working toward, but man, they're such perfectionists. I love it. So, with that being said, I'm going to recognize a few of these students. It's a really difficult task to figure this out, but I think they're very deserving of it. We'll talk about the Outstanding Woodwind Award first. And we'll do outstanding awards for each, like, family of instrument, and then we have some other individual awards that you guys will see. Outstanding woman. This young woman is someone who strives for perfection, always works hard in class, and always has an ability that is nearly unmatched. She made all-region as a 7th grader and 8th grader, made all-region orchestra, and is playing pretty much college-level material for her solo and ensemble competitions. I have some really phenomenal players in this band, but she's quite possibly the best player I've had in my 10 years of teaching. She's absolutely incredible. So winning the Outstanding Woodwind Award is Olivia Vibrokes. All right, for Outstanding Brass. This young man is an amazing player, has a heart of a lion, and is dedicated to being the best musician he can possibly be. I'm constantly amazed by his ability, his work ethic, and his leadership in the band program. He made all-region as a 7th grader and 8th grader. He made all-region orchestra. He consistently gets first division ratings on his solos and solo ensemble, except for the two for the duet because he didn't have his music. Winning the Outstanding Brass Award is Adrian Salazar. For Outstanding Percussion. This young man has constantly pushed himself to be the best he could possibly be. Often sneaking into the band room at odd times of the day just to get a few reps in on what he's practicing. Literally, he'll beg me to leave the door unlocked just so he can sneak in and practice during passing time. It's ridiculous. He would also sneak into the high school bandstands just to stand with the older percussionists to watch and learn from them. He made all-region as an 8th grader, all-region orchestra this year, and consistently gets first division ratings at a solo ensemble. The Outstanding Percussion Award goes to Andrew Wheatman. Okay, we have a special award that we do at Kirksey Middle School called the Timothy Hicks Spirit Award. I had the pleasure before Ms. Thomas retired, and she had been doing this award, and I thought it was really great because I had the pleasure of actually meeting Timothy Hicks. Timothy Hicks is the kind of kid who has so much spirit and so much heart, and he's encouraging, and he loves people, and he loves music, and he's just got a passion for it. And he found a nook with a band, and he stuck with it. And we want to recognize a student in this aspect who really fits that kind of build. And this kid works really hard, diligently. He receives all kind of awards. He's kind of quiet in class for the most part. And he loves music, and he actually even, this will probably give away for some of you guys, you know, he actually has a YouTube channel where he sometimes plays. He will bust out some famous like Disney songs and stuff like that on Tremolin. It's absolutely incredible. So, winning the Timothy Hicks Spirit Award is Jacob Peter. I swear every day I have on my board somebody's written subscribe to Pete Flicks. I don't know. Jacob, you might be famous someday. Up next is a different award. This will be the second year that we've given this out. This is called the Esprit de Corps Award. And this is someone who embodies a sense of pride and fellowship in the band, has a lot of friends in the band, and just really just loves the atmosphere of it. This young woman constantly achieves great things in her band throughout her tireless hard work and dedication. She embodies a sense of unity with her friends and band, and she's a perfect example of what an excellent band member should be. I could have given this award to many people, but I think she is very deserving. Winning the Esprit de Corps Award is Johanna Chang. Okay. And our last award is called the Director's Award. This student has gone above and beyond for the band. This young man, his second home is basically the band room. He's in there after school almost every day practicing. He's in there before school hanging out with his friends. He stays after school to practice, helps me in any way that he can. He always gives me really good feedback, and that's one thing I love about these band kids is I can ask them for their honest opinion, and they'll tell me straight up exactly what's wrong and what's right. Mr. Moore, you're terrible at that. You should fix that. Things like that. It's awesome. I love it. And he's one of them. He's nice about it, and he really is very encouraging. He also loves talking about drum corps, fun horn pieces. He likes talking about the ins and outs of music theory, and there's no doubt that this young man has a love and passion for music, and he'll do great things in life. Winning the Director's Award is Rune Hawkins. We're going to close this concert. I believe I've said everything else. Yeah, I'm good. The last thing I do want to say is thank you guys so much for your support. Thank you for our administrator's support. It's been a phenomenal experience having a symphonic band and a concert band. And I can't thank my principals enough for making that work in the schedule. It's been incredible. The other thing I'd like to say is, isn't the shell really nice that we're playing in? Oh my gosh. Round of applause for the administrator. We're still learning how to play on it, so if you hear the percussion playing really loud, I'm sorry, we're just not used to this show. They kind of pop a little bit. The last thing I'll say is it's been an honor and a pleasure working with these kids every single day. I can't say that enough. And one of the things that they don't realize is it's coming to a close very quickly. And they're going to look back, and I hope that they look back with fond memories on their middle school band career, and that they really enjoyed it to the fullest. Many of them, I think this is the largest group I've ever had that's moving straight on to the high school and doing high school band, and I think they're gonna find a lot of joy in that because it's so much fun. And I'm definitely gonna miss these guys, and I hope they have enjoyed every minute of this. So thank you guys so much, I appreciate it. This is our last song we're gonna play, Oye Como Va.